I would now like to introduce our next speaker of the day, Tricia Vail. Tricia Vail has been working for Sartorius since 2019 as the LPS NA segment marketing manager supporting QC/QA testing. With over 20 years of experience in microbiology and filtration in various markets, including foods and beverages, water, air, cannabis, cosmetics, and pharmaceuticals, she has become an expert in her field. Tricia is an active member of ASTM, ANSI, AWWA, AOAC, and ISO, and serves as a MAC board member for AWWA and the AWWA Journal Committee. She represents the United States on a multitude of international and national standardizing committees focusing on test methods for microbiology and analytical chemistry. Currently, Tricia is working on standardization within standard methods for PFAS testing. She holds a Bachelor of Science with a concentration in biotechnology and microbiology from the University of Massachusetts, Lowell, and has a passion for helping all industries progress with testing. Thank you for joining us today, Tricia. Please feel free to begin.
Welcome to the Sartorius presentation titled Beyond Contamination, Sartorius Lab Water Systems, Key Role in Precise PFAS Detection and Compliance. During this presentation, we'll cover a few things. What are PFAS and where can they be found? Health concerns of PFAS. We'll do an overview of the Sartorius Arium Lab Water System, experimental design of LCMS, our experimental design of the TOF method via CIC, and conclusion. What do a raincoat, cosmetics, and food packaging have in common? PFAS. As you can see in this infographic, PFAS is everywhere. But the question is why? Well, mainly because there are a lot of favorable properties of PFAS, which have made them very useful in so many different types of consumer goods. They have high chemical and thermal stability, low surface energy, and more importantly, they're fluorosurfactant. So they're fluorinated, which gives them the hydrophobic tail and hydrophilic head. This is why it's in cookware, clothing, firefighter foam, paints, cosmetics, water, everywhere. Over the past several years, there have been numerous studies to show the harmful effects of what PFAS can do to the human body. Mainly because of all of its really great properties for use is part of the reason why it's so harmful. It lingers in our bodies and can cause multiple health challenges. Cancers of many different types, organ tissue damages, thyroid disease, kidney cancer, there's mammary gland development delays, there's low birth weight. And one of the biggest problems is that developmental effect on the unborn child. And here's a little bit of food for thought. Since PFAS lingers, and if a mom is carrying a girl, then all of her daughter's eggs are also in development and exposed to PFAS. Hence, the mother's grandchildren will also be impacted. This now becomes a triple generational threat. Now we'll take a quick look at our Arium Comfort 1 UV water system. It has the capability to produce ASTM type 1 and type 3 water in a single system from tap water. It features the state-of-the-art reverse osmosis technology and unique cartridge for the highest ultra-pure water quality, which is key in reducing PFAS. It's environmentally friendly, reliable, and easy to use, with a unique touch display and intuitive menu navigation. And the great part about this system is there are other options which can be added to the system depending upon the different types of quality needs you have for your system. This includes a TOC monitor, UV lamp, and others. Here, we're looking at the flowchart of an Arium Comfort 1 system and how it can reduce PFAS. First off, we're looking at a pretreatment cartridge. This has highly effective activated carbon. It's the first stop in reducing PFAS in our system. Next up are the RO modules, Module 1 and Module 2. Both of these, in combination with the carbon bed, highly reduce the levels of PFAS, which can come from tap water. Lastly, we have our Arium Comfort Kit. The combination of all three of these unique and highly effective treatments for PFAS reduce tap water, which may be very contaminated, to non-detect levels, which is needed for any PFAS testing. Sartorius offers a wide range of different water technologies that can be used within your laboratory. These technologies include reverse osmosis, ion exchange, UV treatment, TOC, sterile filtration, and more. We also offer a range of solutions in different sizes, different volumes, all based upon the different types of needs within your individual laboratory. This water can come in different types of quality depending upon your needs, including type 1, type 2, and type 3 ASTM grade water. These water systems can be found in numerous different types of markets, including pharma biotech, diagnostics, and food and beverage. Please scan the QR code and you'll take directly to our laboratory water page for more information. When setting up our experiment, we had several key factors that we wanted to verify. First, we used two different Arium Comfort 1 systems. The first system had our standard setup with PE and PTFE tubing. The second had no PTFE tubing. We had two separate experiments set up for each system. The first experiment was to mimic a normal lab setting by connecting the system directly to a tap water. This tap water was known to be highly contaminated with many different types of PFAS compounds. In experiment 1, we had three different sample points. Sample point 1 was the tap water, which gave us our baseline. Sample point 2 was post-RO module, and sample point 3 was post-point of use. The second experiment was to spike the 50-liter bag filled with reagent water with additional PFAS to test the system's capability. The first sample point was the reagent water itself. Second sample point was post-50-liter bag for spiked PFAS concentration. Sample point 3 was post-RO module, and sample point 4 was post-point of use. The experimental design for the LCMS method was created and conducted by our independent contractor, Claros Technologies. They utilized the EPA draft method 1633 due to its more complex nature and requirements than other methods. At each sample point, 500 milliliters was obtained in an HDPE bottle with liner-free caps. All the results which are going to be reported to the method are at the reporting limit, and that's calculated based on method detection limits. Here are the results for experiment 1, which is a comparison between the two setups. Remember, setup 1 is our standard tubing, which includes PE and PTFE. Our second setup is a system without the PTFE tubing. Both systems were set up in Woodbury, Minnesota, which is historically known to contain high levels of PFAS in water. All the units are reported in parts per trillion, and as you can see, no PFAS is detected post-RO and before the 20-liter tank for both setups, and no PFAS detected at a point of use for either setup. To test the Arium 1 Comfort's capability and capacity, the back tank was spiked with 40 different types of PFAS compounds. As you'll see here, these are all the different starting concentrations of that water. All these results are reported in parts per trillion, and we do have a few caveats to mention. Although we spiked one 50-liter bag with the different PFAS compounds, the two setup experiments are 1 week apart, which resulted in an interesting discrepancy of the starting concentrations. Also, it may be difficult to mix PFAS well with a 50-liter water bag in practice. Unless you're able to hold a significant amount of weight, it does present itself as a bit of a challenge. The chemical nature of PFAS itself may result in the heterogeneous distribution within the 50-liter bag. And also, some PFAS compounds are not stable enough at room temperature. Here are the results for experiment two, for samples post-RO and point of use. You'll notice that there's only 6 compounds being reported. The other 34 analytes had a non-detect level at both post-RO and point of use. Another thing to note is the difference between the start concentrations for the two setups result in the differences in concentrations for post-RO sampling and point of use. The analytes have a starting concentration at part per billion level, and by the time we get to point of use, there is no PFAS detected. The results match well with the previous study showing that RO is efficient in reducing PFOA, PFAS, and PFOS in water. Here's the summary for the LCMS data. The Arium Comfort 1 UV system produces reagent grade water that is suitable for testing labs that do the PFAS application. There are no major differences in tubing between the standard setup and the PTFE free setup. The Arium Comfort 1 UV system can reduce part per billion level PFAS to non-detect levels. And as always, PFAS is that type of application that constantly throws us a curveball. Before we start getting into TOF and the results from that study, I first want to go over what TOF is. It is total fluorine minus the inorganic fluorine. There are other ways to test for organic fluorine. You have AOF, EOF, you have LCMS, which can also do speciation like we saw previously, and there's also PIGE methods. The great part about TOF is that it does see all organic fluorine and not just certain compounds of it. So now let's take a look at the experiment for our TOF methods. Here is the experimental design for TOF via combustion ion chromatography, or CIC. This was done by our independent contractor, Novum Scientific. They utilized the same experimental design and sample points as the LCMS scheme. The method of choice is CIC to analyze TOF per sample and compare to the LCMS data. TOF is non-speciated and therefore looks at the combined PFAS impact. It also has a considerably less sample prep, as only 10 mils of sample are set up and scheduled to run on CIC. The best part about TOF is it can give an overall look and insight to unknowns relatively quickly, and it may not be needed to do any sort of next level testing or speciation. Here we're looking at the TOF data. You'll note that all the results are reported in part per billion. The regulations state part per trillion. Part to remember is that TOF is looking at all compounds of PFAS, even the ones which are not part of the speciation requirements by the regulations. Those regulations are set to part per trillion for those individual species of PFAS compounds. You'll also note that the results are reported in less than 7.5. This is due to the level of detection of the instruments. But a key thing to note here is how the results in both System 1 and System 2 marry up to the LCMS data. Here's the summary for the CIC data, or the TOF data. The Arium Comfort 1 UV system produces reagent grade water that is suitable for PFAS testing labs. The TOF data complements the LCMS data. This is key. All the non-detects were verified, and that system 2 increase after the 50-liter bag was also verified. The impact of PFAS contribution was verified, as there are no hidden analytes driving up the total organic fluorine. And although the TOF method sensitivity is still in development, the data is useful to ensure that non-standard or all of those other PFASs which are not speciated by regulations are not elevated. Thank you for spending time today to listen to me talk about the Arium 1 Comfort System and how it can reduce PFAS in your tap water down to non-detect levels, which is important in your own PFAS testing. If you have any questions or want more information about the LCMS method, please reach out to Beryl. If you're interested in learning more about the TOF method, please reach out to Andrew. We thank you for joining us today.